Hi everybody, I got some more food for thought, more philosophy for you. Today, our topic is going to be your words. Many of us want to say things, or we feel that our opinions are very important, and of course we spill out things that we feel emotionally, and sometimes we say things that we never think about. The power of words in itself is either very destructive or constructive. I want a lot of you guys to really consider some of the things that you say from this day forward. When we are talking to other individuals, sometimes we need to be mindful of what that person is going through and what that person is experiencing and what that person's background and life is all about. By understanding where they're coming from, can we truly communicate with that person? Sharing our opinions or advising people or helping them through communication is a wonderful tool. But often we use our own selfish interpretations and explain situations according to what our narrow minds and our views are. The principle of laying down and spitting in the air is when you lay down and you spit up, because of the laws of gravitation, the spit will come back into your face. When you guys are saying things or you're trying to educate people, try really not to be adamant or certain of what you say, because you never know when you're going to be disproven. But one thing you should never do is say things that are demeaning, destructive, slandering, insulting, and of course, unmeaningful. It's better for us to continue in our lives saying words that encourages people, that helps people, and including helping yourself as well. To educate and enlighten is only an opinion as of what true knowledge we really don't know. And only the universe and all the aspects of what's in it can we really know. And unfortunately, we'll never get to that state in our short lifespan. What you don't want to do is lay down and spit up, because the spit comes back down on your face. And when you spit up, this is when you're spitting up. It's when you're insulting people that you don't know. It's when you say something flagrant, or you say something that is obvious in the eyes of intelligent people, that it's out of malicious, jealousness, envy, or even racist, or anything that's out of dislike or hate. Intelligent people can read, and they can also reason, and logically come to conclusions. So a lot of you guys who think that you guys are wise, or what you're saying is very wise, I want you to understand, anything outside of love, very unwise. If you value anything in life, we should value what we say, because people remember the things you say. Of course, people remember the things you do, but most of the time, people remember what you have said. Now, a lot of us think that we hold a lot of knowledge or we're very wise, but in essence, we're not wise at all. And life is a forever learning experience. So when you say something out of your mouth, I want you guys to realize, or you type something on your keyboard, I want you to realize what you say, you can't gather it and put it back into your mouth. So if you say something productive, good for you. If you say something destructive, remember, your words are tattooed in the hearts and minds of people that you're speaking to. As human beings, we shouldn't be ignorant, but to spill out ignorance and hate is truly something that's really unwise. Now, we all want to say things that are intelligent and wise. We surely don't want to be stupid and proven wrong. And the only way you're going to obtain that is literally this: to say nothing at all. And because we can't say anything at all for the rest of our lives, we do have to say something. So I ask all of you to consider what you do say and how you say it. You can help and create much better things through words of love and encouragement. than you will with hate and insults. The more reserved you are in your words, and the more carefully selective you become of your words, the less the errors of mistake will be. So when you do say something, I want you guys to consider this, and for you haters out there as well. When you guys comment on something, thinking that you know something, what you're going to do is find out that other people have difference in opinions. And their difference in opinion is something that you can take constructively. But if it's blatant insult, or they're just trying to demean you, you'll know the difference. Now, when God created the beginning, God said, okay, something He said. He said, let there be light. And according to the Bible, there was light. Now, you can say anything you want. Doesn't necessarily mean that something is going to be created. Or it is going to create an emotion or a feeling. Now, whether it be positive or negative, it's up to you. But I advise you to say things that are positive, that are loving, that are meaningful, that are educational, that are encouraging, and most of all, share things out of the kindness of your heart to help people. And for those who continue to say things that are harmful, demeaning, slanderous, insulting, or simply just bad things, I want you to know that's a reflection of what's in your soul. Now, you can change this through your own efforts by simply, when you have nothing good to say, don't say anything at all. And if you want to say something, you want to tell that person out of love, kindness, encouragement, and a sincerity to help that person. Now, through your words and its power, I want you guys to really think about this. There are two things that you should always say. One is, whatever is the truth. And number two is, anything of love. Anything outside of that is meaningless and maybe even irrelevant or redundant. It's not wise to act intelligent, but it's wise to act like you don't know and absorb and become intelligent. So I encourage all of you, when you choose words, choose it wisely. And say things of kindness, love, and always respect other people's opinions. So I ask all of you to really consider your words, because your words can either create or it can destroy. Let's encourage moral and good conduct, and let's say through our words what's procreative, productive, and encouraging. Not only for yourself, but for all humanity. I ask that you guys meditate on your words. Thank you for listening. See you guys next time. God bless you and your whole entire family. We'll see you guys next time.